Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn how to plot graph from a data using TGraph in root. So suppose you have some data file which contains two columns x and y, where first column represents x coordinate and second column represents y coordinate, and we want to plot x comma y on the graph. So for that you can use TGraph class. So let's open terminal, and when you write root minus l, so here you can use this interpreter to search for the commands which you will need. So if you want to use the class tgraph, so you can write tgraph, so tgraph class, and then the method tgraph, and you can press tab. Yeah, so it will open all these options. So there are various ways through which you can use this constructor to declare an object. So in our first method we will use this argument, where this first argument is file name, the second argument is the format of the data present in this data file, and the third argument is used for options like delimiters. So we will declare a tgraph star gr equal to new tgraph. So now the first thing is this data 2.txt. So it will, I press the tab, it completed that, and you can close the bracket. And so now this gr is declared. So you can, so after this arrow you can press tab, and it will show all these methods or functions available for this tgraph class. So here you can see lots of them, and we want to use this draw option. So if you write dr draw and press tab, and you again press tab up after this bracket, so you can see there are few options. We will not be using any options in this tutorial, and that we will see in the next tutorial. So we will just close it and enter. So you can see that it has created a canvas C1 where it has plotted this nice curve, and the data is plotted from this data2.txt. So you can see that this data2 file, yeah. So this data2 file was having first column as x, second was just the x square. So that's why we obtained this square curve. So here you can see these data points are kind of small dots which are hidden behind this line. We will see in the next tutorial how to change their shape and type, and how to change their color, and how to make them large. So all those things we will see in the next tutorial. So here we will just see how to import data into the tgraph class. So we are going to look for few ways. So suppose you have three columns, 1, 2, 3, and you have some line with a hash. So in this method of plotting graph, this line starting with hash will be ignored, and these first two columns will be plotted if you do not give any options in the format. So here the second column is just the 2 times x, so it is 2x, and third is the x square, the one we saw in the previous data file. So before we start that, this next file, I would like to go out of this interpreter method. I mean, you can keep on writing codes in this interpreter, but if you have lots of lines to enter, it will be a little bit inconvenient. So it's better to write them in a separate file which is called macro. So we will write a macro, and so tgraph, let's say data file dot cpp. So here we will declare a function tgraph data file. So this, as we saw in the last tutorial, this name should be same as the name of the file. This name of the function should be same as name of the file. So we will write this here, and gr draw. can just go out of it, root minus L T graph, and you can press tab to complete this sentence. And when you enter, you can see the same graph is drawn again. So it's much better than writing all those lines here. So suppose now you want to draw this third data3.txt, which has three columns. So you can use up arrow to get the previous command and enter. So now you can see it is a straight line, as I told that was 2x. So you can see the x-axis is going from 1 to 10 and the y is going from 2 to 20, which is expected for 2x. So suppose you have this data file where there are some delimiters like these commas which are separating data points. So you want to tell your code that there are delimiters which are commas. So that we can give in a argument, but even before that I would like to show, suppose you want to plot three columns, first column and third column, and want to skip second column. So you can do that with this formatting. So we will write %lg %lg will be written for all those columns which we want to include, and we don't want to include second column, so we will write star. So we can just now, yeah, so you can see now it is this square curve which was the third column, and it is coming from this data3.txt. Now suppose you have delimiters, these commas, and we want to also mention that there are these delimiters. So you can add one more argument, comma, in as a third argument, and here you can write delimit and you can save. Yes. So now this graph is plotted from this data3delimit.txt. So suppose you have one more kind of delimiter, like you have comma as well as colons, semicolons, so that you want to mention, so that you can mention here itself, comma and semicolon and this. Yeah, so I have changed the file name. Now you can again see it is safely taking care of this commas and colons. If you do not put this, it will show error while reading the data file. So in this method we plotted the data which was already present in the file. Suppose you are calculating some number and you want to plot that result into using this T graph. So in that case this method will not be useful. So for that we can use other method to declare our T graph. So let's look at other methods for declaring T graph. So you can press tab. So you can see this method where we have this argument, three arguments. So in this method we are going to use array. So this first argument is the size of the array, which means the number of data points. The second is the array for this x coordinate, and third is the array for y. So let's declare a macro. So we will write T graph, let's say array dot cpp. So void T graph array. So we will first declare two array, and I will just declare 5 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then double y, 1 and this is 2 2 4 9 16 and 25. So y is just the square of x. So now we will declare t graph star gr equal to nu t graph. So the first argument is the size, which is 5 in our case. The second argument is x array. Third argument is y array. We'll close this and we'll just draw. Let's see whether it works. So we will write dot x and t graph array dot cpp. So we can see that it has drawn this square graph, and these kinks are the point where these data points are present. So in this method of array, you need to know the size of the array. But what if you don't know the size of the array or the number of data points which you are going to plot? In this case, we need to go for some other method where we can use, like, where this data number of data points are not defined. So let's say we can, so here we are going to use this TGraph method where this argument is not given, and for we can set point one by one. So we can just look at this method TGraph, we can look at set points. You can press tab and it will complete. So you can see, once you declare this TGraph with an empty argument, you can use this method or function on this gr set point, where there are three arguments. The first argument is the index of the data point. For ith index, it will be I, and the second is the x coordinate, third is the y coordinate. So that we will be using while entering this data point. So let's declare a new macro. So we will write TGraph, and this, let's rename it TGraph point dot cpp. So you can declare this function TGraph point. So first we are going to read from this data file data2.txt. So we'll declare a file handle. So if stream in file and in file dot open data2.txt, and we will have two doubles x and y where we will read this numbers from this data file. So we will be using while loop. So while in file x y, so these data points will be read from in file and will go into, first number will go into x, the second will go into y, and the while loop will go till we have something, we have read something. And if this x and y are empty and it hasn't read anything, that time this while loop will complete. So you can do cout also to check whether it's working or not. So you can see dot x t graph points. Yeah, so it works. So we can comment this out, and we need to declare this t graph star gr equal to new t graph. Here we don't need to give any argument, and we can just, now we can use this set point. First argument will be, we need to declare one counter. So let's see integer i equal to 0, and we will write plus plus i. This will be the index, and x comma y, and now we will just draw it. Yes, let's see. Yeah, so it has drawn all these 10 points which were present in this data2.txt. So this was the method where we added data points point by point. In the next method, But in this method, we haven't saved this data point in our program and we haven't done any calculation, because if we want to save them into array, then again we have a problem that we don't know the total number of points in the array. So for that, we can go for a hybrid approach, which is a vector. So I mostly use vector for my programs, because there I don't need to worry about this total number of data points in the list. So we have just copied this, and okay, so we will declare a new file. So tgraph vector dot cpp. So we will just copy paste that. This vector also we are going to read from this data file itself, and we will need this double, but we will need one this vector of type double. So we will just name them x list, y list. We do not need this counter, so we will just remove it. We can remove this also and this also, and this thing we will need later. So here, once we have read this x and y, we will just push them into the list. So we will use this method pushback. So this x will go to this x list and y will go to this y list. So now once this x list and y list have data x and y, now we can declare here. So this method is also same as this method which we used for array, where we need first the number of points, the second this address of this first element which is stored in this pointer x and pointer y. So but with vector we have one advantage, that vector knows how many points are there. So we can use x list dot size, so this will give us the number of data points in the x list. And next we need to give this address of the first element, so this will be ampersand and then again ampersand y list and zeroth element. So in this way we can declare a graph tgr tgraph gr, and now we can use we need to declare dot x t graph an array, and we also need to change vector, not array. So we need to change this to vector, and let's see. Yes so here using this t vector this graph has been drawn. And so these were the four ways through which you can declare tgraph and plot graph, and out of these, this vector one is the most convenient one, which I mostly use, and I hope it will be helpful to you. And in the next tutorial we will be learning how to change this line color, and this how to show these markers, and how to change their style and color. So please like this tutorial if you find it helpful. Once you like it, it helps the video to get more visibility, and then more people will be able to get the benefit. And I will put all these codes on my website, and the link for this website will be given in the description. Thank you for watching.